Hi, Yasmin.
Hello.
How are you today?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm very good. So happy to have you here.
Thank you.
I'm so happy to be talking to you today about your brand.
Thank you.
So first of all, I'll start by asking you, what was the inspiration behind you finding the brand?
I found a gap in the market for not only like modest sportswear. I found like a lot of my friends who wore hijabs, it was like always falling off and it wasn't very comfortable with like layering of clothes. And I'm like really into like organic lifestyle and healthy eating and nutrition. So I thought to encourage Muslim women in sport and to participate in sport, it's got to start at the core of the brand. So all my garments are completely organic. So it's all from agricultural land, so it's not harming the environment. Mm-hmm. So it's like sweat resistant, it's cooling, it's breathable. So it's like for personal hygiene. Mm-hmm. So not only are we like, promoting like personal health and hygiene, we're also like helping the environment and the plants and sustainable.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, but you come from an Arabic origin, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so your mom covers, or who was your inspiration to like, you know, try to found, you know, a brand that is specifically for modest women or modest women in sports?
I think because I have been exposed to both cultures, and like I love Egypt and I love like the Middle East, but I also love the West. And ever since like growing up, I've always been really inspired with how like Western influences and trends are like really like inspiring the Middle East, and how fashion and lifestyles are becoming more integrated, especially through like social media and like retail globalization and multi-channeling. Now like we see like Arabs dressing in Zara, wearing hijabs, and they're so fashionable, and like we see the West now taking inspiration and coming to Dubai. So it's all about like world integration.
Okay.
Yeah, so I really enjoy like mixing both cultures. I perhaps you're the same. I really like take inspiration from like Western trends, lifestyle, like going for brunch. And I wanted to create a lifestyle brand, so not just a fashion brand, but like that's why I do like the organic fabric, so they can wear like the loungewear, which is like for traveling, for airplanes, walk the dog, go for brunch, and then things like they can participate in sports, like the hijab separate, the what I call my skite, so it's like a legging with like a skirt covering, so it's not showing like
too much
of the hips.
Yeah.
Exactly. But I don't like to limit. I don't like to limit to the Muslim. I like to. My brand to be like for everybody, to like whether you're Muslim, non-Muslim, women of faiths and ethnicities.
And where are you based?
Based in the UK.
In the UK, okay. And do you export your products, or how do people order your brand?
So we do international online shipping. Inshallah, we're going to be in Dubai soon.
Yay!
And I also sell via ASOS marketplace.
Okay.
As well, so they do international shipping, so any country, anywhere, like we're available on my website, and I will ship internationally.
And how's your brand doing currently in the UK?
It's good, and both I see both Muslims and non-Muslims buy as well, and also in Turkey, women who cover and don't cover, because not everybody's comfortable wearing like crop tops and leggings to go to the gym.
Mm-hmm.
So I see, and because I focus on trends as well, I'm very much inspired like vêtements and like Kanye West. Mm-hmm. Like Yeezy.
Yeah.
So now we see like a lot of like oversized trends anyway, so whether you dress because you want to be fashionable or you dress because you want to be modest, it's more about like individual style and champion the like oversized trends, and as well as obviously like covering modestly as well. So hopefully there's like something for everybody in the collection.
So which month are we looking at for Dubai?
Which month?
This year, like 2018?
This year, this is going to be under us.
Let's put you under pressure, you know, so we hold you accountable for it.
I hope so.
Summer 2018?
Inshallah.
Inshallah.
Inshallah, I hope so.
And my last question would be like, how much of the Muslim woman representation is currently available in the world, and do you want to see like more of it or less of it, or how do you feel about that? Because like, as you know, for example, you know, all the sports brands are finally, you know, starting to notice, you know, that we exist as athletes, and they're trying to cater for Muslim women, and I feel like we are starting to come out in a way, like especially women who cover, and you know, they do cool things.
I definitely think because of like the whole retail globalization and social media. There's what we call like today's hijabis, hijabistas. So they're really like influencing like styles and trends. And I just think if there is now London Modest Fashion Week at the same time as London Fashion Week, and there's now like New York Fashion Modest Fashion Week is going to come this year or early next year, then obviously there's demand for it. It's growing and it'll keep growing.
Amazing.
And like we said, like until people realize that modesty doesn't only mean like Islam, it's like it can be for everybody.
Yeah.
It will just keep growing because everyone will take inspiration from modest wear and they will express it however they wish to express it, because it's about fashion now. There's no limitations. You know, people dress however they want.
Exactly.
Like boys look like girls. Sometimes girls look like boys. You know, it's about expression. It's about individuality. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have like Ashanti, J-Lo, Rihanna wearing turbans and head wraps, you know, and since the 1950s, like Audrey Hepburn, you know, wearing like a turban, or so it doesn't necessarily have to be up to date.
Yeah,
exactly. But it's lovely to see that there is demand and mainstream fashion designers and mainstream sports brands, because if Nike are doing it, there must be demand for it. So any smaller brands, for me, it just means that I'm going in the right direction because there's demand for it.
Correct.
Yeah. So hopefully what keeps me from the market unique is that, obviously, with being a sportswear, it was really important for me to do organic fabric.
Right.
Because I just think for personal hygiene as well, and all my fabric is like, if you have sensitive skin, it's kind to the skin. And
I've never heard of an organic brand here in the Middle East. I think this is new of its kind.
Well, to be honest with you, there's not any sportswear brands, whether it be like Nike or Adidas, Sweaty Betty, Lululemon, who actually focus on organic sportswear, which I found quite strange because it is actually better for like your skin as well. It's actually more hygienic. It's actually kind to the skin. It's really soft on your skin.
Yeah.
It's breathable. It's lightweight. Therefore, it's always like enhancing your performance.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I was quite surprised like to see that not only are we missing fashionable modest sportswear, but we're also missing organic and sustainable sportswear.
Yeah.
So I wanted to kind of like hit the nail on the head.
Yeah.
And because I've been like kind of developing the brand for like the last 2 years, everybody said to me, just do the modest sportswear, there's a huge market. And I said to them, no, because there's so much demand will come from the modest sportswear market, that if I don't do organic, a big brand will come and do a sport hijab.
Yeah.
And Nike did the sport hijab.
Exactly.
I know. So what makes me unique from like the bigger brands is the organic, and that it's like, obviously, like I just like to implement kind of like personal health as well.
Yeah, yeah,
so I want like girls.
Are you vegan?
No.
Oh, okay.
But everyone does say to me, are you vegan? I'm not vegan, but I love cooking.
Eat healthy,
so I can do like vegetarian food and I make my own protein bars.
Wow.
So I kind of see it as like a lifestyle brand, you know, so not another fashion brand. And with the collection, it's timeless. You know, I take inspiration from like trends and colors and maybe some like different designs, like patterns, but it's about the quality as well, because at the end of the day, sportswear is fashionable and I want it to be fashionable and trend focused, but it needs to be practical.
Yeah.
You know, it needs to be practical. It needs to be hygienic, you know, it needs to be sweat resistant, and it's got to be high tech. Like, I've had interest from like boxers and like athletes such as runners who aren't hijabis that are wearing like the sports hijab just simply because it keeps the hair uptight and it actually stops them from sweating, you know, rather than wearing a cap or,
it's,
you know,
the stability of the hair thing.
Exactly. And if they have to wear like a boxing like helmet, if they wear the hijab underneath, because the hijab's like breathable and really soft, it's obviously like moisture resistant.
Right.
So I've had really great feedback, to be honest. And I think if you work out a lot and you buy a lot of sport clothes, you can really like tell the difference when you buy into organic fabric.
Well, the way that it holds the sweat and stuff.
Exactly. Yep. And the way that it releases and is breathable.
Right.
So yeah. So inshallah,
well,
I'm hoping.
A lot,
no, thank
best.
You. Thank you so much.
We're
and
so
we'll have
excited.
To go for some mochi here in Rushdie.
Oh, nice.